And most inconveniently, I was ravenously hungry. I am going all in.
Satisfied.
100%.
Whoa.
I'm not nearly as hungry anymore. I'm gonna say that again for the people in the back.
So it's been 4 months since I've been all in. And this was basically giving myself unconditional permission to eat to full satiation every single day, regardless of how many calories it was. And these past months have been quite the emotional roller coaster. And I don't want to sound too dramatic, but going all in has changed the way I feel, the way I look at myself in the mirror, and most importantly, the way that I view food. And I didn't just go all in to fix my extreme hunger. I was actually experiencing other issues that I think were a result of being leaner than my body wanted it to be for many years. So after 4 months of eating to full satiation every single day, what happened? Well, I can say with confidence, in my humble opinion, that going all in actually worked for me. This process still isn't over, but I think I've withstood some of the most challenging parts of the journey, and I actually know what it feels like to feel full. And it's actually pretty mind-blowing because I thought it was gonna take so much longer than 4 months. So let's get into some of the juicy stuff that I know you guys are curious about. And I know you guys are really wanting to know, in total, how much weight did I gain? And I really want to keep this brief because weight gain should not be the focus. It's simply just a byproduct of the process of getting me to where I ultimately want to be. And for anyone who doesn't document their life like I do, paying attention to the weight gain is extremely unhelpful. But for the sake of letting you guys know everything that's going on with me, in total, I've gained 35 pounds. Interestingly, my weight kind of capped out at the 3 month mark, and it really hasn't changed in the past month and has more or less stabilized. Now, that isn't to say that I won't gain any more weight, because I don't want to be tempted to have feelings of, oh, my weight has plateaued, so now I can't gain any more weight, which could bring me to a dangerous restrictive mindset. So even though it's currently plateaued, it doesn't mean that my weight won't continue to fluctuate. And in the past 2 months, I've only been eating roughly 2,500 to 3,000 calories a day, which is significantly less than my 5,000 calories a day I was eating in like the first month or two. And instead of eating from like the moment I wake up in the morning to the moment I go to bed, for some strange reason, nowadays, my appetite is like abysmal in the morning. And I usually don't eat my first meal until 11 or 12 o'clock because I just honor my hunger whenever it decides to come around. And I also started straying away from like picking at random foods throughout the day, and I really started focusing on having like a proper meal whenever I would eat, which has been really key for me to get myself into a normal eating rhythm. And that's not to say I won't have little snacks throughout the day. I don't have any rules or anything, but after my first meal, I'm usually good for a few hours and then just eat again when I'm hungry and whenever I'm hungry. So everything related to food and my appetite has been going amazing, and I honestly feel like everything is working for me. Now, as good as some things were in the past few months, I also experienced some harder things and some harder obstacles that I really wasn't prepared for or was really expecting.
I was staying the night at my sister's house, and my mom is there. My sister and I have been spending a lot of time with her because she's been really unwell. And I've never talked about this on my channel before, but I'll say it really briefly. My mom is mentally ill. I don't wanna get into all of it, but she's been sick my whole life, and it's a part of why my sister and I take care of her. And I guess I should have been more prepared for her to have an opinion on how I look, not being herself, because this isn't how she normally is. She had a few things to say about my weight gain, and I honestly didn't expect it to bother me. I guess I didn't imagine it would affect me so badly. She's really off right now, and she's kind of in her own world, but it did really bother me, I guess. And the things that she was saying was basically everything that I'm feeling.
And I do want to give myself a little bit of credit. I think I was handling criticism from strangers pretty well. It was just that when it's somebody that's close to you, that made it really hard. And I felt like the best way to deal with it was just to move on. Otherwise, it was just going to consume me. I was also dealing with a lot of other personal struggles and complications in my life that I don't usually talk at length about on my YouTube channel. And I just noticed that the more struggles that I was dealing with in my life, the more everything else just feels worse and seems more heavy. My sister and I are caretakers to my mom, and fellow caretakers know it is challenging at times. And getting through my day-to-day seemed a bit more difficult the more I had on my plate. And my emotions could have been kind of dictated by my internally changing hormones. I did get my blood work done at the beginning of this process and then again at the 3-month mark.
So today is September 10th, almost exactly 3 months from when I got my first blood work done. So I'm gonna get blood work redone. I'm completely fasted, so your girl's a little bit hungry.
And because I was really interested in the female reproductive hormones like estradiol, luteinizing hormone, and follicle stimulating hormone, I made sure to get the measurements done at the same time of my ovarian cycle so I could compare the number appropriately. And your numbers do vary depending on whether you're in your follicular phase of your cycle or the luteal phase of your cycle. So that's just something to keep in mind when you get blood work done. So this was something that was actually a bit more unexpected because after gaining 35 pounds and having a very regular, albeit very heavy menstrual cycle for the past few months.
So I actually made a vlog last time I had my period. So I mentioned already that while I'm on my period, it hurts really, really bad. And it's the first day and it hurts really bad.
I thought that my hormones would have improved because even though I did have my menstrual cycle when I started this all-in journey, it wasn't perfectly regular, and I figured that after all of this that my hormones would have improved more. But unfortunately, that really wasn't the case. The numbers did improve slightly, but they were still in the lower end of the normal range, and that just kind of indicated to me that it just takes time and that I have to be patient. So I'll let you guys know what happens with any future blood work that I get done. However, on a positive note, I do feel like the goal of building up my strength and making strength improvements was definitely achieved. I felt way more energetic and just better in the gym, like even more than my first month. So everything related to my training and my training recovery only continues to get better the longer I've been all in, which is amazing. However, another challenge I was dealing with that was way more prominent in like the later months than the early months was that the weight gain that I had experienced was becoming a lot more noticeable. So at the beginning when I gained only 18 pounds, it really wasn't really noticeable. Like it looked like I gained a little bit of weight, but once I've gained 35 pounds, the weight gain started to be way more noticeable. And the more that I would look at myself in the mirror, the more that I could barely recognize myself. And at the beginning, I didn't really think that my stretch marks or spider veins, yes, I have both of those, were all that noticeable. But as I started to gain more weight, I did realize that both of those things became a lot more noticeable. And I do use a self-tanner, which hides them pretty well. But when I didn't have self-tanner on, they were extremely noticeable. And I felt like they were way more noticeable the more weight that I had gained compared to when I was leaner. Also, with the more weight that I was gaining, it just got even more difficult to even attempt to fit into some of my old clothes. So I decided to do a way more thorough closet cleansing because looking at my old clothes was honestly just really distracting.
So I just don't want to be surrounded by a bunch of clothes that just don't fit me or I just don't want to wear right now. And I just think it's a good idea for me to just like either put the ones that I might be able to wear again in storage and then all the rest of it, I'm just going to donate. I'm just going to give all of that away. A lot of it, some of it even still has tags on it. So
I was surrounded by a bunch of clothes that didn't fit me. So I just needed to clear them out so I could just have the clothes that did fit me in my line of view for my sanity and ease of getting dressed every day. And so I did decide to donate a lot more clothes this time around, especially the clothes that I didn't think would ever fit me ever again, like the really tiny clothes. And I mainly did this because I really didn't want it to be a goal or a focus of ever trying to fit back into my old clothes. And I know I showed you guys in my first update video that I did buy new clothes, but sadly, even some of those clothes were starting to feel a little bit tight on me. So I did have to go back and buy some more. Ooh, it's a hot day today.
So I just went into Target and I just got a few things from the clearance section. Nothing too crazy. I'm kind of like over buying new clothes, so I'm gonna really try to be very picky when I buy new stuff. It has to be something that I really need, something that I can't like live without. Things like bras and underwears that I can't get dressed without putting them on. I also think it's important for me to buy clothes that I not only feel comfortable in, but that I feel good in, because there are so many other like contributing factors to my self-esteem right now, and feeling like I look like a hot mess and being up in weight is not going to be very good for me mentally. So I do want to feel and look good, but not being like wasteful and buying just things frivolously.
And this is kind of random, but I thought it was kind of interesting, so I'm going to throw it in. Some of the struggles that I was dealing with in my first month, I didn't have to deal with anymore. So in my first month, with all of the food that I was eating, and it was just such a big change for my body, I was just so sweaty all the time. I was not only hot, I was just really sweaty, which was kind of gross. But the later I got into this all-in journey, I feel like my body started to balance out, kind of get used to the food intake. And I rarely ever got cold. I was still really hot all the time, but I wasn't nearly as sweaty. And I really do think that over time, my body was really balancing out because I no longer had bad edema or puffiness. My swelling and bloating got significantly better, but don't get me wrong, I still got bloated. I still had my fair share of food babies. But because the overall puffiness went down, some of you guys even thought that I had started losing weight. But my weight never went down during this process, but it just stopped increasing and my swelling just went away, which probably gave me a bit of a leaner look. All in all, I feel amazing. And yes, I still have bad body image days, because who doesn't? But I feel great and my mood has generally been in really good spirits. But something that I really struggled with that I'm going to shamelessly admit was that for months 3 and 4, I was actually not with Jeff. Jeff and I were apart for those months, and I really noticed how much not having him around all the time like really affected my mood. He was my daily cheerleader, and he always made me feel really good about myself. So without him, I do have to admit that I felt really alone, and I let things get to me that normally don't get to me as much, and I started letting people's opinion of me, regardless if it was positive or negative, really get to me.
Lately, I've been feeling way more stressed than usual about what I'm doing. The main reason is because of how open and publicly I'm doing this. It does subject myself to a lot of other creators who have public platforms to commentate or to react to what I'm doing. For the most part, a lot of people are really supportive and positive. I think regardless, it's still brings me such a wave of anxiety every single time I see the thumbnail with my face on it or a title with my name in it. I just feel that when these moments or feelings arise, that when I do talk about it, even right now, to a camera that's sitting on a desk in front of me, in front of a window, nobody behind it, even though I'm talking to an empty camera, I know there'll be a day that this is inserted into a video that I create. There will be somebody on the other side of the camera, on the other side of the screen, that is going to see this one day. So I do feel less alone, but in this moment, in this room, myself, in my empty house, with no one behind the camera, I do feel alone.
But since Jeff and I have been reunited, things have been so much better. And we actually filmed a video together. It's like a really candid and fun conversation between the two of us. So if you missed that video, I will link it down below. I highly recommend checking it out. And a few months ago, I also did have another call with Kayla. I like to keep these calls pretty regular because she's always just such a pleasant reminder that what I'm doing is so good for my body and that everything that I'm experiencing is completely normal.
That's just kind of the struggle that I've been having right now, is like assuming and wanting things to move faster than they're going to.
Yeah. Well, that's completely normal. Like, again, like, you're not alone in that feeling. I think that almost everyone has that feeling. You can't speed up things quicker than they're supposed to go. Mm-hmm. But, you know, if you're able to realize like, okay, this is normal. Like if I just can accept this sooner and let go of the fears and the doubts, because those are so normal.
So what's next for me? Well, like I said so many times, this journey is not a quick one. And by no means do I feel like it's gonna be over anytime soon. So I just plan to continue doing what I'm doing because I really do feel like I'm on the right track. And I'm just gonna do it as long as it takes for my body to fully recover. And eventually I feel like I'm just going to be living and continue to do all the things that I love, like lifting weights, eating especially, and just being a better version of my previous self. So yes, I do plan to continue to document this journey as I kind of still feel like it's still in its infancy. And I hope that you guys will continue to follow along as the end product will probably be as much of a surprise to you as it is to me, because I still feel like I'm learning every single day. And each day I do feel like I'm getting better at accepting the new me. And I know I say this all the time, but I can't thank you enough for being as supportive as you've been throughout this whole journey. I know that you guys said that you would in my first all-in video. You guys all promised me that you would stick with me, but I definitely had my doubts. And you guys proved me so wrong. And I feel grateful for you guys every single day. And I appreciate you so much. And thank you for helping me get through probably the most difficult part of this journey. And now that I kind of feel like I'm on the other side of the hill, I hope it will start to go a little bit more smoothly, but probably not, because this process isn't easy and I hope we can just continue getting through it together. So that is it for this update. I really hope that you enjoyed it. Like the video if you did like it, subscribe if you happen to be new. I'd love it if you stuck around, and I will see you in a video really soon. I love you so much. Bye. I need you more.